Hello friends, I welcome you all to Nandip Academy for UPSC and MPSC. In this segment, we are going to analyze multiple choice questions that are based on the Hindu, dated 30th December 2020. I would also like to share with you that all the multiple choice questions that are based on the entire month of December on the newspaper The Hindu are available on Nandip app. So this is going to be an advantage for you, where you will not only get the MCQs, you will also get an explanation and analysis of the MCQs along with the answers. Both the MCQs, the answers and the analysis are available on Nandip app. Let's move to the first question. Consider the following statements. The share of women who are anemic has risen significantly in 2019-20 compared to 2015-16. In Maharashtra, the share of anemic women has surpassed the levels that were recorded in 2005-06. Which of these statements are correct? A. Only one. B. Only two. C. Both one and two. Or D. Neither one nor two. So, we need to understand what is anemia. Anemia is a condition in which the number of red blood cells or the hemoglobin concentration within them is lower than normal. This results in symptoms such as fatigue, weakness, dizziness and shortness of breath, among others. The most common cause of anemia include nutritional deficiencies, particularly iron deficiency, though the deficiencies in folate, vitamin B12 and A are also important causes. The share of women who are anemic has risen significantly in 2019-20 compared to 2015-16. Anemia continues to affect higher share of women than men. Andhra Pradesh has performed better than all the states in all the indicators of the National Family Health Survey. Let's move on to the second question. Which of the following is not true regarding Digital Ocean? A. It is an initiative of the Ministry of Health and Science and Technology. 2. It is a web-based platform to provide heterogeneous oceanographic data. 3. It will function as a one-stop solution for varied users. D. It will play a central role in blue economy initiatives. So here it is A, which is incorrect. It is not true regarding the Digital Ocean project. Let's see why. And let's see what else we need to know about Digital Ocean. INCOIS is an autonomous ministry under the Ministry of Earth Sciences, and it has launched a web-based application which is called as Digital Ocean to share information on marine data and forecast services. The INCOIS, or the Indian Center for Oceanographic Information, provides ocean information and advisory services to various stakeholders, including data that is based on oceanographic research, advisory services such as fishing zone advisories, ocean state forecast, high wave alerts, tsunami early warnings, and storm surge and oil spill. The Digital Ocean platform includes a set of applications developed to organize and present heterogeneous oceanographic data by adopting rapid advancements in geospatial technology. The platform will serve as a one-stop solution for all the data-related need a wide range of users, including research institutions, operational agencies, strategic users, academic community, maritime industry, policymakers, and the public. It will play a central role in sustainable management of our oceans and expanding our blue economy initiatives. So that is about the Digital Ocean. Let's move on to the next question. Why are Rohingya refugees in news? A. Massive persecution by Bangladesh. B. Massive persecution by Myanmar. C. Relocated from Bangladesh to an island. Or D. None of the above. So here the answer is C. They are relocated from Bangladesh to a nearby island. So let's see, what else do we need to know about Rohingya? The Rohingya people have faced decades of systematic discrimination, statelessness, and targeted violence in the Rakhine state of Myanmar. Such persecution has forced the Rohingya women, girls, boys, and men into Bangladesh, and all of them have traveled and reached the Cox Bazar district of Bangladesh. Cox Bazar, Bangladesh is now home to world's largest refugee camp of the Rohingya refugees. They are being relocated to Bashan Char Island, which is 34 kilometers from the mainland. The island surfaced only 20 years ago and was not previously inhabited. It was regularly submerged by monsoon rain, but now has flood protection embankments, houses, hospitals, mosques, built at a cost of more than $112 million by the Bangladesh Navy. International aid agencies and the UN have opposed the relocation since it was first proposed in 2015, expressing fear that a big storm could wash over the island and endanger thousands of lives, which the Bangladesh government is transporting to this island. Let's move on to the next question. Who is Zhang Zhan? A. Journalist, B. Doctor, C. Politician, or D. Sportsperson? Zhang Zhan is a Chinese citizen. She is a Chinese journalist, and on Monday she was sentenced to 4 years in prison for having found guilty of picking quarrel and provoking trouble to the Chinese government. She is a 37-year-old citizen journalist, and she is facing backlash from the Chinese regime for covering the coronavirus outbreak in Wuhan. While in Wuhan, Zhang reported from various parts of the cities, its crowded hospitals, and also documented the arrests of journalists and harassment meted out to the families of those seeking accountability. Zhang has also been arrested in 2019 for speaking in support of the activists in Hong Kong, and that is why the Chinese government has arrested this journalist. So that is all for the multiple choice questions based on 30th December. See you in the next online session with the next new set of multiple choice questions. Thank you.